David H.
What have you got left? 168?
Where do I go? See what coming
in. Where do I go?
118.
Apparently mine's paid.
Is
this? Good old Sky, aren't you?
Well, George, the other old girl out of Carlos Wallace, she couldn't jump.
Somebody's hanging into the back.
Are we going to get going?
Right, Pat said there's no woodcock today, which is the first thing. It's cocks and hens, obviously, and partridge, anything else basically. No ground game whatsoever. If there's, like Mark said yesterday, if there's a fox sitting right next to you, just leave it alone, please. The main thing I'm after is safety, obviously, today. Just as long as there's sky there, don't be blowing things up too much. You know, I'd rather the cocks were shot instead of the hens, but you know, if you've got two coming towards you, if you can try and be a bit more selective, I'd be grateful. Basically, that's sort of about it, really. Dean will be standing the guns today. There's no pegs. We're not picking pegs or anything like that. We're just trying to try and get everybody some shooting, you know, depending whether you hit them or not, but you'll all have some shooting. We've double banked people in places. When I'm walking the woods, I'm going to ask a few of you maybe to put your guns in your slips just when we're walking, just for safety more than anything. I don't want too many people shooting in the line. If people want to walk, just come up to me and say, you know, I want to walk this drive or something, that's fair enough. But I'll try and stand as many of us, you as you can, sort of thing. And just be safe, that's the main thing, and have a good day. And hopefully make sure he's behind you before you start shooting, please. Belinda is up by then.
We're going to be flat on the floor by then.
Hurry up, my arm's aching. Get it up, grommet.
If you can't, because I've only just put it up.
Yeah.
About
you're good, lad.
No, he's not. Yeah. I don't know, I'm heavily done here.
Yeah, just as we turn the corner there.
How can you take a picture in the dark?
Good picture.
How do you get on Saturday night then, Pete?
Atmospheric.
It's Monday night.
Monday.
Last night.
Even.
What happened?
Are you a bit tired?
You're the only person I've ever met.
She like Hobbit then.
Is it one just in there?
Yeah.
Oh.
Come in there!
Come here.
mate.
Who's got the taste of that old stuff?
What's that?
Take Chris with you.
Timmy,
all right out there? Yeah. You don't want to mess with your old man without there. Just let him work the dog up the hedgerow or something. Have you heard that from them, Gina? You can throw the white cockbird cake back last week, remember?
Three
bucks.
Yeah,
you get down there, yeah.
I'll see him shot. The buck that's running through is velveting on his antlers.
Yeah?
Mm.
That's a bit early, isn't it?
It is a little bit. Come sideways!
Right.
It's okay, they're shooting that way, my darling. It's alright. Yeah, it's okay. Okay, Pete, on the left. Hey, 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 hey. Thank you. Blimey!
Good boy!
Dead, dead, dead,
good boy! And it went up there and I thought, Jake!
There's one. Wait.
Ray Seymour is coming in. All the loose change I can find.
Much as that.
Hang on, look. Hey. No, I've got that here, Peter. For another 42p. Go on, spend it wine.
Breaks for brewing times. For breaking with the position.
I noticed everybody with money ran from the bar. I just thank all the guns for coming beating today because obviously it made it a lot easier for everyone else. And it was a nice turnout of guns really today. I thank all the beaters for this year basically because without them we haven't got a shoot. And they've done a grand job this year, never let me down. I've always had plenty of people and I am very grateful. Basically, thank the pickers up who obviously aren't here, which is a shame, but they've done me.
Eric's here, but he's
always been here.
Is he a picker up? No, his dogs are.
And Dean for today, stood the guns, and that was one less hassle I'm going to have to think about.
He was shooting
all that. He obviously got where he wanted to stand, but never mind. Thank Pat for all his help, really, over the season. He's always helped me with everything I wanted, sort of. We've done basically to make the shoot as good as it is today, really. And just say thank you, basically. Brilliant. Thanks very much. Well done, Peter.
Support for NPR comes from Capella University, an accredited university committed to delivering academic excellence online at capella.edu.
He made his first banjo out of a cigar box, a stick, and some string. Today we play his music in remembrance. Narvin Kimball, the last founding member of the New Orleans Preservation Hall Jazz Band, died yesterday at age 97. Known for his vocals and for the way he worked that banjo, his professional career began in the 1920s playing on Mississippi riverboats. He formed his own band, Narvin Kimball's Gentlemen of Jazz, and he eventually found his way to the steps of Preservation Hall. For more than 40 years, the musicians of the Preservation Hall Jazz Band have served as ambassadors and guardians of New Orleans jazz. Kimball did have somebody to care for him in the end. He died at his daughter's home in South Carolina, where he and his wife have been living since Hurricane Katrina. That's All Things Considered from NPR News. I'm Debbie Elliott.
can't find it. Oh, it's a dandelion.
Six.
Certainly the best feeling in the world when you know that the match is in safe hands. The Reverend's wife Deborah's over here from Dubai to watch him play at his best this season. So he has certainly not played at his best in this tournament so far.
Thank you.
Over 40 in this match, including two centuries, could have had three maximums. It was an awesome performance from Paul Rev, and he's beaten last year's world champion Sean Murphy. And they're both true gentlemen of the game, and both congratulating each other. Great match, congratulations, Paul Rev, and commiserations to the former world champion, Sean Murphy.
Well played, Peter Ebden, and well played too to Sean Murphy. He has been a terrific world champion these last 12 months, but he joins the other 14 men, 14 first-time champions who couldn't come back the next year and reclaim the title. Now, before we go, let's update you with what's been happening in the other match this evening. We saw Mark Williams go three frames behind. It's only two now,
24.
Because the last couple of balls here. Mark is certainly still in this quarter-final. Now trails by 9 frames to 11 against the Rocket. They're currently at their mid-session interval. Yep. And we will be coming back in a little while, 20 past 11 in fact, to see how this one concludes. But we just got enough time just to say, how do you fancy one of these boys going through? Which one is it going to be?
You still really match it in the land of the gods, really, as far as I'm concerned. Really, I said I've obviously got the edge, but Mark's, it's very difficult to sort of shake him off.
Mm. And in terms of Peter's performance against Sean Murphy tonight?
Superb. And then the first round match with Michael Holt, it was a struggle in the end, 10-8. And since then, he's got better over David Gray. And of course, today was excellent. So he's never the big shout.
What kind of pressure will Ronnie be feeling at the moment, would you imagine, with Mark off on his heels?
Well, we'll just be looking for chances. That's all you can ask for. I mean, he's playing well enough, but so is Mark. All you want to do is get your chances, and if you don't take them, well, that's up to you.
Okay, well, gents, it's been a fascinating evening of snooker. Thanks very much for sharing it with us. But we are coming back at 20 past 11 this evening to see how the semi-final lineup will look. We'll go through Olivia Sullivan, Olivia Williams.
Here comes the question.
Hello.
Which football club won the league sure. and cup double in 2002? Yeah. A, B, C, or D? All vote now.
Go on. Go.
90% saying Arsenal. 8% Man U, 1% Liverpool, 1%.
Definitely
Arsenal. So are you going to say that anything else?
Well, I don't know Arsenal. Definitely Arsenal, yes.
Final answer?
Final answer.
That's the right answer. You've got £2,000. Do you have psychic feelings?
Sometimes.
Okay, it's beautiful. Well, it's worth £4,000.
Okay.
All right, mate, so fingers crossed. The next voice you hear releases, if you tell you the question, there are still four possible answers. One of these is worth £4,000. All right, mate.
No problem.
Here, Lisa, lots of luck. Time starts now, okay?
According to Wordsworth, what were beside the lake? Okay, thanks.
Good luck, mate.
Thanks.
Bye.
Yes. Right then.
Yes.
Focus his mind.
Yes. Hello.
David?
Yeah?
Hiya, it's Chris Tarrant here on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Good evening.
Hiya.
Now, I've got Daddy here.
Oh, I've got you, mate.
Yeah, well, otherwise I wouldn't rug you, really, would I? He sounded a very nice guy, but why would I ring? Chris Brown is here. He's doing rather well, but he's stuck.
Okay.
The question is worth £64,000.
Right.
Right. Okay, so no pressure from Dad, then. Next one's here will be Chris's. He'll tell you the question. There are still two possible answers. One of these is worth £64,000. Okay.
One's worth £8,000.
All right,
thank you.
Okay, fingers crossed. Lots of luck. Paul, your time starts now.
Hi. Who starred as Simon Sparrow in the 1954 film Doctor in the House? Dirk Bogarde or David Tomlinson?
Yeah.
You would like that?
Yeah.
Yeah. She'd like you?
She probably will do now, yeah.
Well, Lance, you sound very confident.
Yeah.
It is Dirk Bogarde. You just got £8,000. Right, you have one lifeline left. You still have the promising sounding Ask the Audience lifeline. You have 8,000 at this moment. Question number 9 is for 16,000, you're two away from 32,000. Have a look. This is for 16, but it's getting a bit of a big old drop here, Paul. If you do give me a wrong answer, you will lose 7,000. So take your time, have a good look. You have one lifeline. The song The Battle Hymn of the Republic is sung to which tune? John Brown's Body. My Grandfather's Clock, Marching Through Georgia, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
Not a clue. Not a clue.
I'll
have to ask the audience.
Okay. Audience, let's try and get Paul up to £16,000. Here's your question. All on your keypads, please. The song, The Battle Hymn of the Republic, is sung to which tune? Now, A on your keypad will be John Brown's Body, B will be My Grandfather's Clock, C, Marching Through Georgia, D, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. Look at their little faces. Okay, all on your keypads, all vote now. It's worth 16,000. For the 9% say John Brown's Body, it's quite high. 11% My Grandfather's Clock, 15% Marching Through Georgia, 25% Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. And it's up to you, it's worth 16,000.
Yeah, they're usually right. How many here, mates? I won't gamble anymore, but
they're usually right.
I know they've been wrong, but.
Yes.
All the names if they get it wrong, so.
I got their names if they got it wrong. Gonna play?
Yeah, I'll go for that.
Tell her that Debbie thinks the answer's A. Although less than half the audience.
I'm gonna go out.
15 is this. Which Grand Slam singles title did Sue Barker win in 1976? US Open. Wimbledon.
go. Is that it?
Porridge, Nick. Porridge.
What about sausages? Hang on. 30 happy campers. One of me. I make that pin the cloth, don't you? Oh, the manager. I'd like a sea view. Oh, and a paper in the morning, please.
Talk for up to 60 minutes, pay for just 3. With Vodafone, stop the clock.
Je sais que je suis là que depuis 3 jours, mais si ça vous dérange pas, je vais partir.
Take our 3-day test drive and you'll know for sure that a Vauxhall's right for you. Contact your local Vauxhall retailer to book yours now.
Truth or dare?
Dare.
Lick the fish.
No.
Lick it.
No.
Lick it.
Right, it's time for our 9 remaining contestants to play fastest finger first. Hot seat's ready and waiting. Here comes the next question. Starting with the earliest in the year, particularly with this competition. Horse eat horse. Dog eat dog. Cat eat cat. Monkey eat monkey.
It's dog eat dog.
Dog eat dog. You got 100 pounds. Number 2 for 200. Here it is. Complete the phrase meaning to get out of bed quickly. Rise and glow. Twinkle. Shimmer. Shine.
That's shine.
Nice and shine, £200. Just a minute.
Look at the way they're looking, they're both looking over that edge of that basket. Look. Hello. Time for a biscuit race. Good boy, cupboard. Good boy, cupboard.